Hey everyone guys, myself Neha Gupta. I'm your mentor for daily current affairs for phase 1 of RBI SEBI and NABARD. So guys, let me inform you that this PDF is downloadable. You can download it from the Telegram channel of ours. And on that note, let's begin with our first question. So which bank has been ranked as the best private bank in India at the Global Private Banking Awards 2021? So guys, here the right answer is option A, HDFC Bank has been ranked as the best private bank in India. Now you need to understand that these awards were given on the basis of the countries. Therefore, there were a lot of countries and the most important country for us is our India only. Therefore, the award that is important for us from the exam point of view and from general point of view as well is the award for India, which is India's best private bank, and that is HDFC Bank. Now, which organization gives this award? So this award is given by Professional Wealth Management, which is a publication of the Financial Times. Okay, so Financial Times in itself is a newspaper and it publishes this Professional Wealth Management, and this PWM basically specializes in analyzing the growth strategies of private banks. So it assesses the performance of the private banks and the regional financial centers in which they operate. Okay, so that's all about this Global Private Bank. Bahut choti si news hai, and in this only you need to remember only this much, that HDFC Bank has been given this award and the Professional Wealth Management is the organization that gives this award. Now, why do I tell you to memorize the organization that gives the award? Because there are many organizations. For example, there is one publication named as Asia Money. So that is also releases its own list of banks that perform well in the Asian market. Okay, so if you don't remember the organization that is releasing a particular list of rankings or awards, then you will confuse, okay, which award has been given to which organization by which organization. Okay, so that's why I tell you to memorize the organization as well. Moving ahead, which company has received the contract for supplying single shot anti-armor weapon 84 to Indian Army and Indian Air Force? So it is option ASAAB, SAB, which is a Swedish defense company. It has received the contract from the Indian Armed Forces. Now this weapon looks like this. So it will be used by the Indian Army and Indian Air Force. Okay, now the purpose of this vehicle, as you can see, that it can be carried by a single soldier and it will shoot the bomb, or you can say the big size bullet. So that will be shot by using this 84 weapon, and it can destroy major structures, landing crafts. It can also destroy helicopters and it can destroy armored vehicles, as well as it can also be used to shoot the personnel of the other army. Okay, so that's the use of this weapon. And do remember that the power of this weapon is defined by the warhead, that is the bomb or the bullet, whichever you want to say. So the caliber of that weapon is 84 mm. Okay, so that's another peculiarity regarding this that you need to know. Moving ahead, how many companies stocks will be assessed in the Nifty Midcap Select Index? Now recently, National Stock Exchange has received the permission from SEBI for launching its derivatives on the Nifty Midcap Select Index. Okay, that is why it is in the news. And second reason for which you need to know about this index and the whole concept of derivatives is because your SEBI examination is coming up. Now the right answer to this question is option A, 25 stocks are assessed on this Midcap Select Index. Now from the name itself, midcap, that is the stocks that will be traced by this index will be of the companies that have a mid-size capitalization. Okay, I hope that you are aware of the classification of the companies on the basis of capitalization. One is the small cap companies, the other one is mid cap and the large cap. Okay, so this index will particularly cater to the mid cap selected 25 companies, and on the basis of their performance, it derives the values for the investors. Okay, so that is all what is written here. Now guys, what is a derivative? What kind of contracts or what kind of future contract, option contracts, or what are the options under the derivatives? This is a purely financial topic, a purely securities market markets topic, and I hope that you have already covered it in your static portion. So I'm not going to repeat that topic here, and if you haven't covered it yet, then those topics are covered in our static course of finance. So go through the topic of derivatives from there, because this is one of the important topics that can be asked from a SEBI aspirant in the examination. Okay. Moving ahead, who is the present chairperson of the Insolvency and Bankruptcy Board of India? Navrang Saini has been given the additional charge of the chairperson of IBBI. Now, IBBI was established in order to implement the Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code of 2016, and this board not only implements the law, but it also regulates the entire profession of the resolution professionals. Okay, so it is implementing the law as well as it is undertaking the regulation work for the resolution professionals. How will they perform, and what kind of regulations will bind the resolution professionals? All of these cover under the IBBI. Okay, so that is all about this question. Next question is, which Indian airport has been ranked among the top 10 large international airports in the world for its on-time performance? So here the right answer is Chennai International Airport. So regarding this news, let me first inform you that a list of top 10 international airports has been released, and that list basically ranks the airports on the basis of their performance on time. What is the time of the departure, whether the flights are on time, whether the departure of the flights on time or not. So that's the on time performance that is being talked about here. Now let's delve into the news in detail. So Chennai International Airport has been ranked at the 8th position with a score of 89.32%, which is a really good score. Now it is put under the large airports category, which is again an unimportant part of the news that you can purely skip. Next is that this entire list has been released by Cirium, which is an organization that provides the data on the airports, and basically it provides the data related to the aviation. Okay. Now let's have a look at the list of the airports. So clearly you can see that there are more than 10 airports. It's the list of total 20 airports, but definitely we do not need to go into the details. Just know the top one, which is this Itami Airport. Okay, and the 8th one, that is the Chennai Airport. Now guys, this task I am leaving on to you, that in which country is this airport located? Tell me that in the comment section below. Do a bit of homework so that you can memorize what you have learnt in the class better. Who is the author of Ratan N. Tata, the authorized biography book? So here the right answer is Thomas Matthew. Apart from this, nothing is there to be remembered. Now guys, all the questions for the day have ended. It's the time for the GK Factory section. Many a times you come across missiles, okay? So the topic of today would be missiles. How many categories are there of missiles, and what kind of missiles does India have? So all of this we are going to discuss in the GK Factory section. And believe me guys, if you are going to shut the video right now, it is going to be your loss, because there are a lot of interesting things that you will get to know during the course of the GK Factory section. So do listen to me, be a little patient, because here you may not know that maybe you will come across a new kind of classification of the missiles or a new kind of information that you might have not heard before. And let me tell you that the information that I am going to give you is not only relevant from the general perspective of the general awareness, but it can be asked in your examination also. So I have picked up the topic, I have created the entire topic in an exam relevant manner. So on that note, if you want to watch this video, let's begin. So before going into the details, here are some doyens of the space program and the defense missile system. Let me put it straight. So the father of ISRO is Vikram Sarabhai. The father of atomic energy is Homi Jahangir Bhabha. And guys, on these two people only, and most primarily focused on him, there is going to be a series, Rocket Boys. I think that has already been out on Sony Live, I guess. So you can definitely watch that series. I'm definitely going to do that. But after the examination, I have also put it on hold after the phase one of SEBI. I'm going to watch this. Okay. So you also have to keep it aside. But yes, Rocket Boys, it seems an interesting series. So what's the harm of watching it if we are getting some information at the same time? So that's a really good initiative of Sony Live. And let me remind you, the Scam 1992 was also released by the Sony Live. So if it is on the same lines, then definitely we are going to enjoy it. Achha, let's apart. Now, the missile man of India is Abdul Kalam. We all know about him, but the missile woman of India, few of us know about her. So it's Tessie Thomas. So do remember her name as well. Now, guys, okay, so we are not going to discuss about this goat here. This is, I have just put here so that I can acquaint you with a very basic phenomenon. That is, guys, this goat is a herbivore. I hope that you all know about it. Okay, it's a viviparous animal. It's a mammal as well. So, here you can clearly see that a single goat is being classified into three different categories, and all these three different categories are entirely different from each other. One is on the basis of the food that they eat, other one is on the basis of the procreation, the third one is again on the basis of the physical structure as well as the reproduction method that the different animals use in the animal kingdom. So can you say that goat is a herbivore but it is not a mammal? Okay, or can you just put it in one single category and not in other categories? No. Okay, so here the basic idea behind introducing you with Miss Missile Goat is that, guys, there can be various classification models as well for a single animal here. So why can't we have the different models of classification for the missiles? Okay, so that was my point, that the missiles are classified on the basis of the types. Okay, whether it is a cruise missile or ballistic missile, on the basis of range, on the basis of the speed, whether it is subsonic, hypersonic, supersonic, on the basis of the warhead, whether it is tactical or strategic. So many classifications are there, and I have tried to put all the classifications in an easier manner in a table. So let's delve into that. So first is the classification of missiles on the basis of type. So there are two types of missiles. One is cruise missile and other one is ballistic missile. Now the cruise missiles, guys, first of all, let me clarify that the cruise missiles are not only the missiles that can be launched from the ships. Okay. So I was under this impression some years back that cruise missiles were only the missiles that can be launched from the ships. So I have got it clarified some time back, but right now I just want to clarify it for you as well, that cruise missiles are the missiles that first of all that are usually for the short range purposes. Okay, so the range of the cruise missiles do not exceed 1000 kilometers of the area of the target area, whereas the ballistic missile has a range of more than 1000 kilometers. Okay, that's just one way of classifying of differentiating cruise and ballistic missile. Other one is that the altitude at which the cruise missiles fly is very low. Okay, it is at the maximum length of a tree. Okay, therefore these kinds of missiles are also known as tree missiles, whereas ballistic missiles go up to the space and from the space they turn to their target. So it is definitely having a higher altitude. Next is the warhead. So the cruise missiles generally have tactical or conventional warheads. Now tactical or conventional warheads are the warheads that are used for explosion. Okay, but the strategic warheads have a radioactive material like nuclear bombs. But this does not mean that the cruise missiles do not carry strategic warhead. They can carry nuclear warhead as well. Okay. engines. So cruise missiles use jet engines and the ballistic missiles use rocket engine. Obviously, ballistics go to the space and then they turn towards their target. Therefore, they need rocket engine, whereas the cruise only fly in the atmosphere. Therefore, they need a jet engine. Now, the area I have already classified this thing that they fly in the atmosphere as well, and because its altitude is very low, therefore its detection by the radars is also next to impossible. Whereas in the ballistic missiles, the detection is prevented by using decoys. Okay, so decoys is another material that is released from the warhead of the missile so that the radar can be confused. Now, the cruise missiles are generally divided on the basis of speed, and the ballistic missiles are generally divided on the basis of range. Now, on the basis of speed, the cruise missiles are divided into three parts: subsonic, supersonic, hypersonic. But does that mean that a ballistic missile cannot be a supersonic missile, or a cruise missile cannot be a medium range or short range missile? No, it is not a watertight compartment. Okay, it's a very general classification that is given here. Okay, as I told you that a goat can be a herbivore, a goat can be a viviparous animal, a goat is a mammal as well. So it falls under all these classifications. Similar is the case with a missile. It can be a subsonic missile, it can be a supersonic ballistic missile with a long range, with a medium range, okay, with a strategic warhead having a rocket engine. So all these kinds of classifications can mix with each other. It depends on the missile and the intention of the missile maker. Okay, now let's delve into the models of classification of missiles. So on the basis of range, short range missiles, which are lower than the 1,000 kilometers, therefore the short range missiles, cruise missiles, generally are the short range missiles. Medium range missiles, 1,000 to 3,000 kilometers. Intermediate missiles, 3,000 to 5,500 kilometers. Intercontinental over 5,500 kilometers. So one difference between cruise and ballistic is also that the cruise missiles are used in wars, whereas the ballistic missiles are used for doing a large scale destruction like it happened in the Hiroshima Nagasaki. However, they were the atomic bombs, not the missiles that were launched. But I'm just saying that if the other party wants to destroy the entire city at a large scale for a long period of time, then they use ballistic missile, because the destruction scale of the ballistic missile is much more in comparison to the cruise missile. However, cruise missile is used in a one-to-one war. Whenever there is a war-like situation, most of the times cruise missiles are used only. Okay, ballistic missiles are very huge missiles with a very huge range. Therefore, they are not used in a one-to-one war, and wars are generally fought on a one-to-one basis only. Okay, we cannot have a war with France or with Germany by going there. Okay, so that's the basic distinction, that ballistic missiles cause more destruction in comparison to the cruise missiles. Okay, they are used for large scale long term destruction. Next is launch mode. So there can be a surface to surface missile, surface to air missile, air to air missile, air to surface anti-tank missile, that is particularly used for destroying the tanks, surface to sea missile, sea to sea missile, sea to surface missile, and submarine launched missile. So all of these basically tells the mode from where the missile is going to be launched. Okay, speed: subsonic, supersonic, hypersonic. Now, how is the speed measured? So the speed of a missile is measured against the sound. If the missile's speed is more than one in comparison to the sound, then it is supersonic missile, and if it is less than one, then it is subsonic missile. So Mach is the unit in which the missile's speed is measured. Okay, less than Mach 1 means that the subsonic missiles have a speed lower than the speed of the sound. Supersonic missiles have a speed that is more than the speed of the sound, and hypersonic missiles means that their speed is more than 5 times of the speed of the sound. Okay, so that's the distinction. now on the right now that we have BrahMos cruise missile, that is the supersonic missile, and right now we are working on the second version of BrahMos, that is going to be a hypersonic missile. So that is under development right now. So the speed of that missile would be over 5 Mach, and the speed of the BrahMos cruise missile right now is more than 1 Mach. Now we are going to discuss all of that later on, but let's clarify the different models of classification. So on the warhead basis, the missiles are divided into tactical or strategic missiles. Okay, so the tactical or conventional missiles carry explosive material that is used for destruction of a place or of the enemy's ships or camps or the bases. But the strategic missiles are used for the large scale destruction. Okay, for example, kal ko agar POK pe we have to attack, then we will use the conventional missiles, not the strategic missile. Ki pura ki pura area hi khatam nahi karna hai, only we have to cater to the terrorist out there. Next is the navigation mode. So guided missiles or the unguided missiles. Guided missiles are those missiles that can be changed. Their targets can be changed after their launch. Unguided missiles are those missiles that whose targets cannot be changed after the launch of the missile. For example, the Nag missile of India is a fire and forget missile. Fire kar do and then forget. Okay, because you have to put the target before firing the missile, because after launching of the missile, there is no mode, no way through which you can deviate the missile from its target. Okay, therefore it is very accurate on which target you have fired the missile, it will definitely strike that target. Whereas the guided missiles, once they have launched, we can definitely change their path. Now there are various methods of guidance, like GPS is used, like wire radio connection is used, then laser kind of connection is also used for guide the missiles to its target. So various methods of guidance is there, but we are not going to go into the methods of guidance of the missiles, because again we have to keep it general. You are not going into the CDS examination or SSB examination, so that you just therefore you just need to keep a very general viewpoint about the classification of missiles, and that too for your understanding of different missiles that India possess. Okay, because question to wahin se aayega. Okay, nobody is going to ask you about this classification. They can ask you about the new missile that India has launched, or the missile that India has exported so recently, or the missile on which India is working. So that's the case. Now on the basis of fuel, this is the classification. The solid the missile can have a solid fuel, the missile can have a liquid fuel, hybrid fuel. Ramjet and scramjet engines are used to give a high speed to the missile. Okay, so if a missile is a sonic missile, subsonic, supersonic or hypersonic, particularly if it is a supersonic or hypersonic missile, then it will use ramjet or scramjet engine. Okay, cryogenic is a fuel basically. So these are kinds of the fuels that are used in the missile. I hope that you are aware of the fact that this entire missile is just a carrier of the warhead, and the destructive material is in the warhead, that is known. This is the warhead and the payload is inside it, and the payload is the destructive material that is there in the missile, and this is the entire vehicle that will transport this payload to the target. And in order to initiate this travel journey of the missile, the fuel and the engines are used. Now let's discuss the types of missiles that India has. Okay, so the very famous missile that India has is the BrahMos missile, the cruise missile, which is a cruise missile having a range of 290 kilometers, and it can be launched from the land, from the surface, from air, from sea as well. Okay, so it can be launched from various modes. It is a supersonic missile, and it's the world's fastest supersonic missile. That is also the case with BrahMos. And recently India has signed the pact or agreed to export BrahMos to Philippines. Okay, so it is a really good initiative, a really good announcement for India that India is going to export the defense goods, that to a missile that it used to procure from other countries some years back. So that's an achievement on the part of India. So do remember this as well. Now, the warhead that this missile carries is the conventional warhead, and it is a guided missile. So it can also its target can also be changed after its launch. And conventional means that it is carrying the explosives, not the radioactive material. Whenever we use conventional or strategic word in terms of warhead, that means either it carries explosives, which would fall under the category of conventional, or it carries the radioactive material that falls under the category of the strategic missiles. Okay, so I hope that this much is clear to you. Now, another point that I want to highlight here is that you do not need to memorize all these classifications. This is just for your understanding of the missiles that India has. Okay, however, cruise hai ki ballistic hai, this much guys you can easily memorize if you watch this entire table 2 to 3 times. I hope that you will be able to keep it in your mind for a long period of time. Now you should be aware of this fact that integrated guided missile program that was initiated by APJ Abdul Kalam, under this program India decided to launch 5 missiles, to develop 5 missiles, and Prithvi was one of the first missiles that were developed under the IGMP, Integrated Guided Missile Program. Then Prithvi, Trishul, Nag, Agni and Akash, these are the 5 missiles that have been developed under the Integrated Guided Missile Program of APJ Abdul Kalam. Your task is to tell me in which year was this program launched by India. Okay, so coming back to the missiles, Prithvi 1, it is for the army. It's a ballistic short range missile, 150 kilometers. Now here, ballistic hai, but its range bahut short hai, lower than 1000 kilometers, and it is so much lower that it is just 150 kilometers. It's a surface to surface missile, and the speed, guys, I was not able to find out the exact speed of this missile. However, it is not very important for us as well at the same time. So it can carry conventional as well as nuclear weapons. Obviously, if a missile is designed to carry the nuclear warhead, then it is definitely capable of carrying the conventional warheads. So it's a guided missile, Prithvi 1. Prithvi 2 is for Air Force. Again, all the classifications will remain the same. However, the range is expanded, 350 kilometers. Prithvi 3 is for the Navy, ballistic hai, 350 kilometers. Again, same. Surface to surface, basically from the ship. From the surface of the ship, it will be launched. Then comes the Dhanush missile. It's the naval variant of Prithvi 3. Okay, so it's the surface to surface, then it's the sea to sea. Basically, from one ship to another ship, it will be launched. And this Prithvi 3 for Navy, it will be launched from the ground as well, from the land, the naval bases, from there to attack the another target, whether it is in the sea or outside the sea or on the land. Okay, and Dhanush is purely the sea-to-sea variant, so it will be launched from ship to attack another ship. Again, it's a conventional and nuclear capable missile, guided missile. Moving ahead, Agni. So Agni has been launched in 6 variants. There were 6 variants, and all of these variants range varies from 700 kilometers to 12,000 kilometers. Okay, so it is medium to intercontinental missiles. So 1 and 2 ka range same tha, then 3 and 4 ka range same tha. In 3 and 4, Agni 3 and 4, the range was expanded. Then Agni 5 and 6, the range was again expanded to make it to the intercontinental level. Okay, so here I have not divided the variants of Agni because the variants have become really old. Okay, now right now we do not, because they are not in the news, it's just a part of your extra general awareness. That's why I haven't put all the variants here. Now Agni Prime is also another variant of the Agni missile that has been launched recently, as in not in the recent years or the recent months. Okay, so it's not a very old missile. Now, surface to surface Agni missile hai, and it is conventional as well as nuclear guided missile. Nag. Now, it is also called Prospina. So, it's a cruise missile, anti-tank guided missiles. Okay, missile. Okay. So, it is before launching the Nag missile, the target is set, and after launching it, we cannot change the target, okay? So that basically makes it an unguided missile, because after launching it, we cannot change the path of this missile. But yes, before launching it, we can guide the missile where is the target. We can set the target. That's the meaning of anti-tank guided missiles. And NAG missile is particularly used for destroying the tanks. The range is 500 meters to 20 kilometers. Tanks to isse zyada dur deploy nahi hote hain whenever there is a war. So surface to surface is the launch mode. Conventional hai ye. Obviously, why would they use nuclear material in the NAG missile when the range is so short? Okay, so conventionally yoga and unguided a fire and forget missile. Helena. So Helena, guys, is the helicopter launch version of NAG. So from the helicopter, NAG missile can also be launched. Okay, and this Helena is also known as Dhruvastra. So Dhruvastra and Helena, both of these missiles are the same missiles. Cruise missile hai, anti-tank guided, again tanks pe girane ke liye hi use hoti hai. 7 to 10 kilometers is the range of this missile, and air to surface hai. From helicopter, the missiles will be dropped. Conventional hai, unguided hai. After launching the missile will go to the target and hit the target. Then SANT, standoff anti-tank guided missile. It is an upgraded version of Helena missile, that means helicopter launch hi hoga iska. So air to surface hai. Moving ahead, another missile that India has is Trishul, which is a cruise missile. 300 meters to 11 kilometer is the range, surface to air. From surface to air, it is launched, Trishul, in order to track down the aircrafts of the other people or the drones particularly. Nowadays, the drones bhi aa gaye hain, so Trishul will be useful in that also. However, in drones, I don't think missile is used, but it was just an example that I gave you, okay? However, it's not the real fact that in drones, missiles are used. No, missiles are not used to strike down the drones. It is used to strike down the aircrafts, helicopters, or such kinds of battlefield weapons or the crafts. Supersonic hai. Trishul is a supersonic missile. It's conventional, it's guided. Akash missile. It's again cruise missile. 100 kilometers is the range, surface to air. From surface, it will be launched to the air, and it is a mobile missile launched. Okay, so basically, mobile missiles are those missiles that are launched from a mobile vehicle, like truck or like a missile launching vehicle. Okay, like tanks or chassis. So supersonic hai again, conventional guided. Now comes Akash NG, Akash new generation. It is a cruise missile, 70 kilometers is the range. Surface to air, again it is also a mobile launched missile. From the surface, it will be launched to hit the target in the air. Subsonic missile hai. Then it's conventional and it's guided. Sagarika. Now guys, K-15 and Sagarika, both of these missiles are the same missiles. And do remember that K family missiles are not only restricted to this K-15 missile only. K-4 Mark, K-4 missile, K-4 Mark 1 missile. There are another missiles as well under the K family, but there are very old missiles. Therefore, I haven't put them here. The most important missiles that were launched in the recent years, recent past, and that are in the use by the armed forces, only those missiles are here. Okay, so K-15 is a ballistic missile. 700 kilometers is the range, therefore it's the short range ballistic missile. Submarine launched, so it is launched from the submarine. Okay, so Sagarika, Sagar se hi, I hope that you can remember it, that it's a submarine launched missile. Hypersonic hai. That means its speed is more than Mach 5. Then it's nuclear and it's guided. बहुत ही खतरनाक है. शौर्य मिसाइल. इट्स बैलिस्टिक. 700 टू 1900 किलोमीटर इज द रेंज. ओके, सो इट फॉल्स अंडर द मीडियम रेंज बैलिस्टिक मिसाइल. इट्स सरफेस टू सरफेस, सो द फुल नेम ऑफ द शौर्य मिसाइल वुड बी फुल. इफ यू वांट टू पुट इट इन द क्लासिफिकेशन एंटायर नेम, देन सरफेस टू सरफेस मीडियम रेंज बैलिस्टिक मिसाइल. मीडियम रेंज हाइपरसोनिक कन्वेंशनल और स्ट्रैटेजिक वुड बी द राइट वर्ड. स्ट्रैटेजिक बैलिस्टिक मिसाइल नेम्ड शौर्य. सो दिस वुड बी द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ दिस शौर्य मिसाइल. ओके, इट्स हाइपरसोनिक, इट्स स्ट्रैटेजिक. ओके, बिकॉज इट कैन कैरी न्यूक्लियर वेपन, न्यूक्लियर वॉर हेड. guided missile. Prahar, then Prahar is the ballistic missile, and Pragati and Pranash. Both of these are the variants of Prahar, and with each variant, the range of the missile has been expanded. Okay, you can clearly see it here. So from 150 to 200 kilometers, so that's the consecutive speed of the of all the versions of Prahar. However, you don't have to know it. You can clearly know this thing, that Prahar has the range of 150, Pragati 170, Pranash 200 kilometers. Surface to surface missile hai, and the surface from which these missiles are launched, that surface is mobile surface. That is, it can be moved from one place to another place. That is truck. Okay, the truck is the vehicle from where Prahar, Pragati and Pranash missiles are launched to hit another target on the land. It's a supersonic missile. Okay, so that means its speed would be more than Mach 1. Conventional hai and it's guided. Next is Nirbhaya missile. It's cruise missile. 1500 kilometers is the range. So that means it is under the medium range. It's a medium range cruise missile. It can be launched from many platforms. It's air launched version. Surface to surface launch to hai hi Nirbhaya ka. Then air launched variant and submarine launched variant are under the development. Okay. So it's a subsonic missile. Conventional plus nuclear, dono kind of warhead it can carry, therefore it's a strategic missile. Then it's a guided missile. Astra missile family, so it's a beyond visual range missile. Okay, so guys, as far as Astra missile is concerned, I only got this kind of classification. I did not get whether it is cruise or ballistic, because we cannot assume it on our own, that since its range is this much less, it is the payload that it carries is very less, therefore it is a cruise missile. No, we cannot classify it in this manner, because we have seen cruise missiles having a broader range than 1000 kilometers. Okay, so it falls under the medium range missile, medium range cruise missiles. Therefore, on the basis of range or on any kind of basis, we cannot classify the missile whether it is cruise or ballistic. It's upon the developer whether they have given the classification, the type of the missile on their own or not. However, the defense people or the defense aspirants would be able to classify it, but because of their in-depth knowledge. However, I don't have that kind of in-depth, specific, peculiar knowledge about the missiles. Therefore, I myself cannot classify it and do not mislead you. Okay. So I have just put it here as it is. It is a beyond visual range missile having a range of 110 to 350 kilometers, air-to-air launch missile. From an aircraft, it will be launched to hit another aircraft. Okay, so air to air, it will be launched, a supersonic missile having the speed of more than Mach 1. Conventional hai, that means it does not carry radioactive material. It is guided. That means after launching this Astra missile, we can change the target of the missile. Mika, okay. So it's a cruise missile, fire and forget, like Nag missile. Ek baar launch kiya, then you will definitely forget. It has a really high accuracy and it is going to hit its target at a very high accuracy rate, because the target has been set beforehand. 500 meters to 60 kilometers. Air to air, surface to air. This missile can be launched air to air and surface to air as well. The surface from where the Mika missile is launched is the Mika vertical launch system. Supersonic hai, conventional, guided. Okay. So guys, those were the major missiles that India has at present, and India use those missiles. So that was all about this section for today and for the entire video for today. How did you like the GK factory section or the entire video? If you have any feedbacks, then you can definitely mention in the comment section below. If you have any topics as well to be discussed in the GK factory section, then you can mention them as well, irrespective of the fact that they are too much relevant for the SEBI examination or for the banking examination or not. If they are relevant from your general awareness point of view, then definitely I will pick those topics for your for discussion in the GK factory section. Thank you so much guys for watching this video. Have a good day. Prepare hard for the examination and crack the exam.